Hello, YouTube. Alright, today I have a few things to review. I went to my local Five Below over down in Delaware, and I picked up a few things. Very cheaply. I paid $10 for all of them. Here is the first thing. That is this... iWorld optical mouse. Now, as you can see, it looks like it's supposed to imitate the Apple Magic Mouse. You can see by the shape of it there. But the reason I bought this is because it fixes a lot of the issues. Fixes a lot of the problems I had with the Mighty Mouse or the Magic Mouse. Things I hate about the Magic Mouse. Number one, it's wireless, which means it's Bluetooth and takes batteries. Number two, it uses touch for scrolling, and that's not tactile at all. And I think that is just disgusting. That's not a way. That's no way to scroll. It doesn't feel as natural. And this thing has two buttons instead of just touch sensors for where your finger happens to be on the one button on the mouse. So this is more of a traditional mouse in the same form factor as the Magic Mouse is. So I'll open my drawer here, get some scissors, and we can take a look at this. I got these at Five Below, again, just to reiterate. Very light too. That's the other thing. This mouse is very light. The one thing I don't like about the Magic Mouse is that it's very heavy. This mouse actually doesn't feel too bad. The scrolling feels a little bit light, but it's a $5 mouse. What do you expect? It actually forms to my hand pretty well if you look at it. Look at that. So, that's interesting. It also comes with a long USB cable instead of the short ones like you get with the Mighty Mouse, which is not the Magic Mouse, but it's an Apple Mouse. Look how short this cord is. Extremely short. Mostly because it was made to plug into the back of a keyboard like it is here. Let's put that aside for now. This one, however, can be put on a desk and the computer can be on the floor without a problem. I like light mice. They feel better to me. So let's take a closer look here. It's an optical mouse, obviously. It says 3D optical mouse on the bottom. Made in China, of course. It's a 5-volt mouse with 100 milliamp, so standard USB. So, what should we do? We should fire up the eMac and give this thing a try. So, I'll undo the twisty here. Undo maybe one or two strands, and twisty it back up again. See how this mouse feels. Start the eMac here. The mouse does appear to work, so. One thing I don't like is that it is, since this mouse is kind of cheap, it does leak a little bit of light. Let me see if I can zoom in on that. It leaks a little bit of light through the bottom here. I don't know if you can see that. Oh, there, you can see it there. See, it kind of leaks light a little bit. That's a sign of cheapness right there, but that's okay. Let's see how this mouse feels. Oh, this mouse, wow! This mouse has insane DPI, actually. It's really fast. That's awesome. This is actually a really nice mouse in that aspect. I'm quite impressed. Let's go to a web page and scroll a little bit, see how it feels. Now it's out of date. Go to dig.com, for example. Go away. It scrolls very well, too. It feels nice scrolling, too. I'm impressed. That's pretty cool. So this mouse is a very good companion to a Mac. I'm very impressed with it. The DPI is really good on it. I'm really surprised. For how cheap of a mouse this is, you get a hell... It's actually not too bad. If you don't like the Magic... If you don't like the Magic Mouse for the reasons that I don't, which is the fact that it's too heavy, it's wireless, and the fact that it doesn't have a scroll wheel, and all that stuff, this is definitely a good mouse to pick up. It's an iWorld mouse that's similar looking to the Magic Mouse. And I actually like this mouse quite a bit. Cheap, but good, is what I label this. So, shut this down. This mouse will make a wonderful companion to my MacBook Pro, I think, because a lot of the mice that I plug into there don't have very good DPI, so I think that'll be a very good mouse to go with my MacBook Pro. I'll definitely be keeping this. It's a nice mouse. Definitely recommended. Yeah. So that's my impression of this iWorld mouse I got at Five Below. If you see them there, they're actually pretty damn good mice. As far as the optical sensor goes, they're very sensitive, so there you have it. Overall, I give this thing a 4 out of 5 because you can kind of see the fact that it's built cheaply, but it's not as cheap as you might think from the feel and the look of it. It actually feels good, though. It doesn't feel like it's going to fall apart in your hand. It just feels really light. Well, there you go. That's the iWorld mouse from Five Below. I have yet another thing to unbox here. This is some speakers that I also got at Five Below. Some USB desktop speakers. I got these for a LAN party, for my LAN party machine. So I can use them up at the LAN party this summer. So let's take a look at these. The concept behind these is they're USB powered speakers, so you don't need an extra AC adapter lying around, which is nice. I doubt they sound that good, but they're not supposed to sound good. They're supposed to work. Quality stereo sound for your computer. So this is another Five Below product, straight from China probably. Take a look at these. How convenient. I can just take the bubble wrap right out. Very light. The grill cloth is surprisingly nice, though. Although you can see the fact that there's a very small driver in there. I don't know if the camera can pick that up. But there's like a, you can see kind of a grill there. It's a very tiny driver in each of these speakers. But here you have these speakers. So you get a stereo 1/8-inch jack, and you get USB for power. So you don't need an AC adapter or an extra outlet. You can just use your computer to power these. So, we'll have to try these out. See how long the USB cord is. It's not that long. It's fairly long, though. Zoom out. It's not ridiculously long, but it's long enough, I think. So, here they are. This pair of speakers from Five Below. They look pretty cheap and nasty, and I'm betting they are, but what the hell, let's give them a try. What I'm gonna do is start up the eMac to give them power. And use my iPod to feed them audio. You can use these for just about any source because it's analog right here. So, there you have it. So, I have an iPod here. Let's feed it some music. So you turn it on with a button right there. Okay, and we'll do a little bit of Huey Lewis in the News through these speakers just to see how they sound. That are being powered by the iMac right, or the eMac right there behind it. They don't get that loud either. When you turn them up, whoops. When you turn these speakers up, they clip really badly. So obviously the amplifier is not the highest quality. These speakers definitely show the $5 I paid for them pretty well. I mean, they don't sound that great at all. But they're not made to be audiophile grade. They're literally just meant for making sound come out of your computer. And they accomplish that task very well, so... You know, you gotta go to Five Below and buy one of these expecting crap. And that's exactly what you get, crap. So I guess next we can plug them into the side of the computer here. We'll just demo how it sounds through the computer. Okay, so I'm gonna play a QuickTime movie through the computer and you'll be able to hear what it sounds like out through these speakers.
Hello, YouTube. These are my two Model M keyboards, and unfortunate news about these, they both have problems. And we'll start with this one. This is a 1992 model. I'll show you the thing right there. It's 1992. It actually has a speaker in it too, which is unusual. You don't see many of these with the speaker in them.
And there you go, they actually produce sound from the speaker, from the headphone output of a computer. So these will be perfect for your LAN. My LAN parties is because they'll produce the sound of the game, they won't produce it too loudly, and these are cheap, disposable, throwaway speakers. I mean, literally, they're garbage. But that's exactly why I bought them, because they're garbage. So they'll be perfect for a LAN party. If they get beat up, if they get screwed up, who cares? They're $5. So, obviously... There's a reason cheap crap exists for if you want to use something disposable, and these are definitely disposable to me. So, Five Below has $5 speakers in case you need a pair of throwaway speakers to use, which I happen to need. So, I bought some. And these, I don't know who makes these. Is there any company name anywhere on them? No. The only clue anywhere is this logo here, and I have no idea what that logo is. In fact, I'll zoom in on it for you, just so you guys can see a little bit better. That logo right there. I have no clue what company that is, but that's the brand of these speakers. They are absolute cheap garbage. I would only recommend them if you need some disposable throwaway speakers. So, there you go. You can pick them up at Five Below if you need them. I'm sure other discount stores like Dollar Tree have stuff similar to this. I don't know for sure, but maybe. But there you have it. That is these speakers. Hope you enjoyed the video, and have a good one, everybody. Ciao.